Now, parking in downtown Pittsburgh, we know, is expensive. Mm-hmm. People who work there, though, every day say it takes a huge bite out of every paycheck.
Same story for people who work in downtown Harrisburg, except for state lawmakers and their employees. Most of them get free parking at taxpayer expense.
Here's Team 4 investigator Jim Parsons tonight.
With bus service getting more expensive and unreliable in Pittsburgh, more people than ever who work downtown are parking downtown. And it isn't cheap. Do you drive to work downtown?
Yes, I do.
What does it cost you to park?
I do a monthly pass, but it's about $14 a day.
$14 a day?
Right here, yeah.
It isn't much better for the thousands of commuters who park in downtown Harrisburg. Leases near the Capitol can cost up to $2,000 a year. But most employees of the legislature don't have to pay to park. There's plenty of free parking for legislature staff in the state-owned garage beneath the Capitol. Senators and House leaders get their own reserve parking spots on a private road leading up to the Capitol. And when all of those parking spaces still aren't enough for lawmakers and their staff, they use tax dollars to get more. The Legislative Budget and Finance Committee recently contracted with the Harrisburg Parking Authority at this garage on 7th and Forster Streets. 9 legislature staffers get to park for free all year. Cost to taxpayers, $14,000.
Should the taxpayers be funding parking spaces for employees of the General Assembly, which has the most employees of any legislature in the country?
No, I don't. I've just heard about that right now, but no, I'm looking at that. I wouldn't think that's a good thing to do. Obviously, there has to be other cheaper parking spots somewhere in Harrisburg.
But legislature reform activist Tim Potts says finding cheaper parking spots isn't the answer. Making lawmakers and their staff pay for their own parking is.
This kind of stuff, it's again that aristocratic attitude that nothing is too good for us, and taxpayers, you're going to just have to live with it.
Tim Potts' Democracy Rising organization wants to get a referendum on next November's ballot that would create a constitutional convention. He says that's the only way Pennsylvania will get real reform in Harrisburg. Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.